Welcome to the third episode of Ask Your Excel Question. This week's question comes from one of our friends who posted this question in the comment section for the previous video. So thank you very much for posting a question. We will be talking about a solution to that question in this video, specifically how to calculate rank on condition. For example, if we have a list of employees and they belong to a specific department, and then we have the performance scores or evaluation scores or some kind of scores or a numeric value for each of the employees, we will learn in this video how we can calculate the overall rank, meaning the first rank would be the highest, the employee with the highest score, and then the 10th rank would be the employee with the lowest score because we have 10 employees here. We will also learn how we can find the rank of each employee within their department. So for example, Andrea has the first rank within the finance department, but Kathy has the first rank within the HR department. The rank is being calculated with a condition. Now let's get started. So let's start with the data. So first we have the employee name, department, and the score information. So the first thing we will do is to convert this into a table, which has tremendous benefits in terms of writing formulas, which are easy to read and understand. Okay, so now the first thing we're going to do is to calculate the overall rank. It's usually the rank function that we would use. So rank of, and then we will say the number. So we are trying to find the rank of this specific number, comma, in the entire list of scores. So for this score, in the entire list of scores, and we would put 0 for descending, because in this case, the highest value means it's the first rank or the best. So we're going to do this. We have the overall rank. Clearly, Kathy from HR has the highest value among all employees. And then Jeff has the second, which is 8.0. And then the third is Andrea, who has 6.8. So this looks all fine. Now let's try to write the formula for ranking within a specific department. So rank within department. So the way to think about rank is with a specific condition, we have to use some other function. We cannot use the rank function itself because rank function doesn't provide, or there is no rank if function in Excel, but Excel has so many other functions that we can use to still end up with a solution. So we're going to use a different function. And before we get to the function, let's think about what does rank mean. Rank of one, let's say the first rank, means that there is no other value greater than that value, right? So that's what the rank effectively means. So let's try to write a formula which will do that using COUNTIFS. So COUNTIFS, count the number of occurrences where we want to provide the range. So we will provide the range of all scores, comma, and this is where we will write greater than, and we'll put an ampersand, and then we will select the specific score. So count if how many times we find values in this list that are greater than 6.8, because we are writing the formula for cell E3, so it means 6.8. And then let's just do that. So what will happen is we will end up with a number which slightly is different from the overall rank. And that's because when we find out, for example, the number of occurrences where it's greater than that, we need to add also plus one. So I'll show you an example here. So Kathy, even though the overall rank using the rank function gives us the number one, but using COUNTIFS, we got 0. And that's because the COUNTIFS function is calculating how many values are greater than this value. When there is no other greater value, then that's the first rank. So in order to implement that logic, we will do plus one. So now you will see that these two columns have exactly the same results. And that's because that is proving to us that this function COUNTIFS is also doing the same function as the rank. And so to make it easy to see, I'm just going to do a sort by largest to smallest, and you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the COUNTIFS function works now to give the same result as the rank. Now we can now add the last layer, which is, can we calculate the rank within each department? So since the COUNTIFS function allows us to provide so many ranges and criteria, we actually can choose the department or department list, comma, choose the specific department for which we are in the row 3 now. So we are selecting this value. And the formulas, you can see that they are much, much easier to read because we converted this into a table. So now we can see that the formula is doing, go and look at the list of all scores, find if they are greater than the specific value of score, and then look at all the department or the list of department names, and then find wherever the department name equals my department. And once the COUNTIFS function gives a result, we will add one more at the end. Press enter. There we go. So now we have a rank within department. So let's just check if it's actually working fine. So let's just sort this by department, and you will see that it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So each department has its own 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in order to verify this, we can also use, you know, what is called as the sort function here that Excel provides. I'm going to go and do custom sort, and then let's do within sort by the department, which is what we have done. Let's also sort it by the score, largest to smallest, and you see that it's still the same, which means that our rank function within the department is working as desired. So within finance, we have these scores, and they have the rank 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so the highest rank within finance is Andrea, who is 6.8. And then within HR, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The highest score is Kathy, who is 9.3. So this is how we can implement the rank with a specific condition. So just to recap, it's a COUNTIFS function. You want to make sure that the value you are sorting or ranking based on, you use that and then use a greater than at the score. And then you can put any number of conditions. So if in this case, we only have department, let's say you have more columns you want to do conditions on, you can still do that using the COUNTIFS function, because the COUNTIFS function allows you to provide more criteria. In this video, we didn't actually touch ranking with ties. For example, if the same score is in within the first two employees. So let's just take Kathy and Jeff. They both have, let's say, 9.3. In that case, both of them will be assigned the rank of 1. And then the next highest within HR will be ranked 3. So there will not be any rank 2 in this case. So this makes sure that the person who's third is still ranked 3rd. But there are some scenarios where we may want to address the ties differently. So we will talk about those scenarios and how to handle them with formulas in a future video. Thanks again for our friend who posted the question in the previous video. I look forward to receiving more questions from you. And if you have any questions or suggestions, please post them in the comments below. And if you would like to be notified about all the future videos about Excel and Excel templates, please subscribe. I will see you all in the next episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.